Hello guys, and welcome to day 4, well not even day 4, it's actually just day 17, but part 4 of the Supremacy 1914 Let's Play. So I am so sorry that I've been gone for a couple days now, 15 days, yeah, that's my bad. Basically, I had to go to school, I had to get everything ready, and I didn't know I was actually taking 3 advanced placement classes, including AP Psychology, which is going to be lovely. So I actually had to read 3 books and write 4 essays in the past 15 days, like a boss. Yeah, and I did that, and I did it like quick, and it's good. So, also, I didn't know that my debate team was actually having a summer camp thing going, so I had to go to that as well. And then I found out, or then all I already knew, but I had to spend time with my best friend before she left for college. Yeah, so now I'm all alone, and the debate camp's over, and I got everything ready, so I guess I'm here, working for you guys. So first things first, I need to say that good news! Since the channel now has over 90 subscribers, that is 9-0. 90. I can upload for over 15 minutes, which is good, because this video is probably going to be a doozy. So, now let's start by going to the old design. Deep through diamond space, we're going to something that none of us have ever used before. That is right, we are going to the old user interface. Mostly because it's easier to show the map, as you can see. It's an old Soviet secret. No, just kidding, I kind of just made the browser smaller. So, I'm going to go through each day and explain what happened. So here we left off, right here, and then Germany was fighting its war with Poland, and Belgium actually took a city. And then day 4, we can see that I took Strasbourg, and I'm actually invading Switzerland and Stuttgart. Day 5, I've taken all Switzerland, and I'm invading Bavaria. And England is invading the Belgium. As England is invading Belgium, England. So then, as you can see, I push forward even more. Germany has declared war against Denmark. Stupid idea. Germany didn't really know what to do. Day 5, we can see I have pushed forward into Germany, and have won basically the war. I have asked England to give me Cologne because it was a double grain, double coal province, and I really needed coal. And he basically said, F you, it's mine. And I was like, oh, that's nice. So I asked him to please hand it over, if not, that's fine. So day 8, I push forward even more. Day 9, let's see, I have taken all the way to Danzig, and I've taken over most of Poland. Day 10, oh, wait, here we go. Day 9, so I've taken over into Poland. Day 10, England declares war with me. Yep. Cologne, Lily, he's taken Lily. By the way, yes, Spain is at war with Morocco, I forgot to mention that. And Austria has been dealing this rather pathetic war with Romania that he really lost too many troops with. So I just keep pushing into Germany, but I actually stop and I send all my troops to face this front. Basically, England had 90,000 troops in Cologne. I was like, ah, crap! So then, day 11 comes along, he pushes into Frankfurt with 11,000 men. And Russia took over Konigsberg. I was like, ah, I'm being surrounded. And then I realized that the guy in Russia actually was one of my best friends. And I forgot his name right now. It's, give me a second, I can think of it. Where is he? He's on my Steam list. Come on, where are you, buddy? God damn it, I have too many friends on here. Where is he? I promised him a shout out. Where the fuck is he? Oh, there he is! Dynex! Yes, he's a very awesome kid. And he helped me a lot. He actually gave me some oil to produce some artillery, which really helped with this invasion of Frankfurt. So, day 12, I cut off the 90,000 men in Frankfurt by taking Cologne. And now, he's cut off. Day 13, I send in some artillery to start pummeling the guys in Frankfurt. He tries to push forwards and take back Cologne. And I cut them off and kill all of the 90,000 men. I lost 15,000 in that battle because I had 115,000 men ready. Basically, he lost 45,000 men in my artillery shelling. Basically, an epic battle. Day 15, I tank Frankfurt, and I start pushing into English Belgium. Yes, very epic day. And Russia starts pushing into the leftovers of Romania that Austria lost, and Spain has declared war against Italy. So, day 16, I have taken all of Belgium. I have kicked the English out of mainland Europe. And also, in this day, England tried to send a landing force into Lille. 50,000 men strong, I only had 10,000. I pulled together 60,000 men along the coast, and one artillery, and completely shelled the crap out of them. I only lost 30,000. He lost 50. It was another epic day. Day 17. I pushed into Kovna, and Russia has pushed into Finland, and right now, as we speak, I am invading Copenhagen. And now, back to the old user and back to the new user interface to show you the recent invasion plans for England and Denmark. Alright, be right back. Welcome back to the new user interface. Yes, now we feel very comfortable, don't we? So right now, we can see that I have troops, 13,000, invading Copenhagen, the last German city. And I'm also planning for an invasion of mainland Denmark, because Denmark took Hamburg, which has oil, and that's the only thing I'm negative in right now. Russia has also invaded Denmark and taken Finland, and I'm also going to take Iceland soon enough. So, we can see I've built trains, I've built factories, and a lot of things. So, first things first is I'm going to move the troops to the front line, which is in Brest, which is basically I'm building an Atlantic wall. Very smart idea. Austria went AI, by the way. He left the game, unfortunately. That would have been really interesting. And as we can see, I'm moving other troops to the Danish border. Basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to launch a dual invasion at the same exact time. I'm going to invade England and Denmark at the same exact time. But Denmark is very small, so it won't be that hard. Here's my glorious French Empire. Yes, it is day 17, and me as France, one of the least likely countries to win, has made it, and I'm in second place. Spain is still my ally, technically. He doesn't do anything for me, and I can tell he really doesn't like me. He has declared war on Italy, which has the largest army. However, Italy also went AI a couple days ago. And so did Turkey. And so did Sweden. But that's normal in this game. That's why I made these videos, to be honest, was I want more people to play. And I hope that new players will play longer because of these videos. So, we can see I've got 31,000 here, 28,000 here, 7,000, 39, 13,000, and 21,000. Basically, I've got an Atlantic wall that I'm soon going to push on into England. Now, I'm going to be honest with you guys, I probably went too quickly in taking Germany. If Italy and Austria really wanted, they probably could have beaten the crap out of me. However, that didn't happen. And faithfully, luckily enough, Spain didn't do that either. So today is going to be the big day. Yes, two big episodes in a row. Sorry, I have a stutter. Let's check England's resources and see where it would be smart to invade. Let's see. England has a very low amount of grain. However, he only has two provinces and only one oil province. The three best provinces to take would be up in northern Scotland, Belfast, and London. However, I know London has the most troops. If anywhere, Irvine's has the least amount of troops, which is why I'm going to invade Irvine's. So now I go back to looking at just troops. Nope, I just took the troops off the map. And taking off resources. Good, I hate this thing. There we go. And I'm going to send the 21,000 in Amsterdam to Irvine's. However, first, I'm going to go up this way, so he doesn't know in total where I will go. Secondly, I'm going to invade Ireland at Limerick. Limerick, the third largest city in Ireland. That's a random fact I know. So they're going to push straight forward. And as you can see, this is a very, very important fact. Notice how my artillery is behind the city. This way, when England invaded Lille, the artillery pounded him The second, even before he reached the shore. So 3 hours of shelling when he was disembarking. Then I also put 3,000 men along these roads, all in 1,000. So it took him even longer to get to the city itself, while my artillery was still shelling him. And then, when the battle in Lille was happening, the artillery was not in any danger, and plus it was still shelling the British infantry. Thus, an epic battle that I epically won. And as you can see, this artillery is also behind the Hog, and it is also covering two entrances into Europe. Antwerp and the Hog. And this one is also covering just one, but a very important one. Now, I'm going to keep my troops in Paris, and I'm going to keep my troops in Lille. Next, I want to look at my invasion of Denmark. Basically, I spared 1,000 artillery, spared one artillery unit for this front. And because he's got forts. And I'm sparing all the troops that are coming from for all of Poland and eastern Germany are going to be sent to the Danish front. However, I'm not going to attack there yet. And this is my main artillery hub in Lyons, which is... I hate the new gold mark thing, which is going to soon produce new artillery. And now I'm also building our factories in Brest, I think that's Brest, yes, and Danzig, which is very good. And as you can tell, I also have trains now, almost everywhere. However, most importantly, in double grain provinces, or double provinces, such as in Berlin, Stuttgart, Nancy, and I'm building one in Cologne, which will be finished in a couple of days. Those are very important, and especially in Ligimos, in Bordeaux. Now, as you can see, I have plus 106 grain an hour. Now, most people would think, oh, this is a perfect situation to get more barracks. However, I know that when I take England, he doesn't have much grain. So I'm going to have to feed all the people of England, which is why I want to take Denmark. Which has only grain. Which has fish and grain and that damn oil province that I fucking need. So, once I take Copenhagen, Aarhus, or however you pronounce that, sorry, and Aalborg, I'll be able to produce more grain, which I will be able to use to feed the people of England, and as well as possibly building more barracks in the future. So, these are the plans for the recent and the past. I hope you guys enjoyed the Let's Play, and I'm very, very sorry about not making them in the past. I promise that won't happen for a while. It might happen again, I'm sorry. It just might. If you guys have any suggestions for music, however, I'd be welcoming to any music whatsoever. I am playing Andrew Bird right now because I really like Andrew Bird, and plus it's wonderful background music, isn't it? He's just got such a different taste than everything else that I like. It's just wonderful. However, if you guys want to hear anything in particular, as long as it doesn't have too many words and isn't too loud, I'll think about it. Alright, this is Commissar Tom with part 4 of the Supremacy 1914 Let's Play. Till next time, take care. See you on the front.